There was trouble in Afghanistan today. A NATO service member was killed by a roadside bomb. It was a terrible week. 41 Americans died that week, most in Saturday's Chinook helicopter crash. At least 51 have died this month. For the U.S., the way out of Afghanistan depends on training Afghans to fight their own battles. American taxpayers have spent more than $27 billion on that training, and we asked Seth Doan to go to violent Kandahar province to see if it's working.
On the front lines, there's more than just fighting. Training the 170,000 soldiers in the Afghan National Army is essential, as President Obama hopes Afghanistan will add an additional 100,000 Afghan troops by 2015 to create an army of more than 250,000 that can stand on its own.
What have you learned from the U.S. Army?
I learned how to shoot and how to search a compound, he says, and how to go on missions. On publicity posters and at checkpoints, the effort is to make Afghans the face of security, even if coalition forces are usually right behind them, like U.S. Army Lieutenant John Cote.
They're the locals. They know, they can distinguish who is who. And if we have a positive influence on them, then they can assist us.
The Afghan saying we keep hearing here is Shona Bashona, or shoulder to shoulder. But while we were working on this story, we saw a number of cases where the U.S. seemed to have to prod the Afghan forces, whether it was to just show up on time or to stay at their posts. In some cases, they would leave checkpoints after our cameras turned off. Are these two forces really standing side by side, or are the Afghans leaning too much on the Americans?
Are the soldiers happy with how these checkpoints are built?
U.S. Army Major Brian Ducote shares an office with Afghan commanders.
What people tend to forget is they're never going to be the United States Army. They're not going to be that. And we should stop expecting them to be that. They're going to be the Afghan National Army. And it's going to be an army that is capable of defeating the insurgency.
But building an army with that capability is a tough mission. Fewer than half of the Afghan soldiers can read and write. Their basic pay is only about $165 a month, and roughly one in four quit after their three-year hitch ends.
How many soldiers will you bring?
Still, Afghan forces add manpower to most every mission, and on average, three are killed in this war every day, sharing the sacrifices with the Americans training them, shoulder to shoulder. Seth Doan, CBS News, Kandahar, Afghanistan.